what this means? It's Catalina's story hour! Again! Oh my goodness! That's because I have so many stories! So, my last video talked about how JT and I first met. JT's stuffy, isn't it cute? Look at that Tiggy. He's a Tiggy, isn't it cute? That's his. Well now, I'm going to tell you about how he proposed. And the video of the proposal is going to be down below as a link in, you know, the description thing. You should watch it. Bring tissues, because you're going to be very moist by the end of this. Well, the video. I don't know about this video. You might be moist by the end of this video, but you'll definitely be moist by the end of his proposal video. Okay. So, it was a couple of years ago. We were going to go to Fur Fright like we do every year. And I had my friends Queen Babylon and Zabu the Circle come down to watch my house and my kitty. And anybody at all who knows JT and myself knows that we never, ever, ever get to our destination on time. Ever. Now, am I suggesting this is JT's fault? No! 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 I would never, ever, ever suggest that. I just come out and say it. Okay, once in a while it's my fault, but I digress. So, we're all packed up and ready to go, right? Except, we're not leaving. Why? Well, he was working on something. I didn't know what it was, but it had something to do for Fur Fright. And we were supposed to leave on Thursday. I mean, it's a 14-hour drive. And I had two panels to run that night. Friday night, I mean. So we were supposed to leave Thursday. We didn't leave Thursday. In fact, were we supposed to leave on Thursday? I don't think we left until Friday morning. And by morning, I mean about 6 a.m. Might have been a little bit later. I'm not sure. In fact, I'm sure it was because we actually had to pull over to take a nap. Now, usually I'm the kind of person that will bug you. I mean, if we have to go somewhere, I'm like, come on, let's go, let's go. Or if you're working on something, I'm going to be like, what you working on? What you working? What is it? What is it? Ha, 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 ha. Nope. I figured if I didn't bug him, he would get done faster. Seemed to be good logic, right? Well, we did finally leave. And I was pissed. Woo, was I pissed. I was one very salty kitty. And everybody who rode with us knew it. I am so sorry. Blue, Origami, Teddy, I am so sorry for how salty I was. But I tried not to complain. I tried not to. Oh, I failed. But we did finally make it there, right? And no sooner do we pull out of the parking lot, I jump out of the car, I go right up to where our room is. We're rooming with our friend Cajun, and I immediately started bitching at him. Ah, rah, 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 rah. Meow, 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 meow. Wow, 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 wow. I was so mad. I think this was the maddest I had ever been at JT, ever. Oh, I was so angry. But I sort of calmed down. And I did end up missing my panels, which was why I was angry. But that's okay. That's okay. The next day I worked in the dealer's den. It was the first time I worked in a dealer's den. I did very well. And I got to sit next to Taru. And I got to sit next to Clem. Clementine Fox. It was so much fun. They are so fun to be with. And so, you know, I did have a good time. And then I... I thought that I had gotten ripped off, and so I stormed back to my room, and JT's come out of the room. He's like, oh my god, what's wrong? I was like, I got robbed. rah! And he just had this look on his face I couldn't read. I just couldn't read it, and I didn't know what was going on. So, I got my head clear enough to call back downstairs and straighten things out, and I realized it was my fault, nobody else's. I just misplaced a ticket. And I told him that, and there was this really huge sigh of relief on him. I still didn't read it right. Oh, by the way, this was Sunday. And he goes, well, I got to go down to the ballroom and set up for a closing ceremony. So I was like, okay. He goes, will you be there? I'm like, yes, I'll be there. In fact, I'll come down in about 45 minutes. He was like, yeah, that's good. So after he leaves, I thought to myself, like, you know, I've been really, really awful to him this whole entire time. I think I'll go down there and, you know, I'll dress up for him. And I put on my favorite purple skirt and my black top. And I was looking for my kitty ears, but I couldn't find them. But, you know, I was like, all right, whatever. Grabbed the camera and I went down, you know, to the ballroom. And I'm sitting on the edge of the stage being goofy and playing with my friends. And then finally, you know, we sit in the front row and... Sorry, I'm playing with the camera and I'm taking these epic pictures of the floor. Apparently the floor is very, very epic to me. So finally, you know, ceremonies start and Bellick says his thing and whatnot. And then JT is up on stage and he starts talking. And he apologizes about us being late, and I had to say, you know, I had to be the peanut gallery and heckle him a little bit. And a few minutes later, he walks over towards me and he holds his hand out and asks me to come up on stage. So what do? I take pictures of him holding his hand out to me, you know, phew. He goes, no, seriously, come up on stage. I'm like, oh, okay. So up on stage I go, and a chair magically appears behind me. I chose sit. It was effective. And all of a sudden, this projector comes on, and there's pictures, and he starts singing. And the song that he was singing to was, I think, called My Delilah or Delilah, and he had completely rewritten the words. And the slideshow was going, and it was all these pictures of when we first met and hanging out in Massachusetts and our trip, you know, to and back from California and everything in between, all the way leading up to, you know, up to the present. And all this time, I'm just like, oh, this is so beautiful. This is awesome. He's singing to me. He's serenading me. Am I thinking anything about proposal? No. Everybody else by now in this whole entire ballroom knows what's going on, except me. And then the last line was, now my darling angel, I have one final plea. And he gets down on one knee. And he opens up the ring box and says, will you marry me? And it wasn't until he got down to his knee did it dawn on me that he's proposing. And I think I was in shock, more so than anything else. I think I was in shock. And of course, I said yes, you know? I mean, this is someone I love and have loved for forever and a day, it felt like. So, you know, I get up and I hug him. He puts the ring on me, and it's this beautiful purple amethyst. And I take the microphone, and I look out towards the audience, and I hold it up, and I say, I just have one thing to say. It's very profound. Was it worth it? And if you watch the video, you're going to find the answer to that question. And even though at that time I didn't really cry, I think, like I said, I was still in shock. Every time I tell the story, I tear up. I'm so emotional, so sad. And so, but it doesn't end. Oh no, 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 no. Does it end there? No! You'd think it would. You know, he proposed. Kitty said yes. They live happily ever after. No, it doesn't end there. So the next day, we drive home. We stop, we drop Blue and Origami off at their place, and we took a nap. And then we head towards home, right? Now, I don't like to travel. Like, I like to travel. I like getting to the destination. The whole driving thing really freaks me out. So I took some sleeping pills and curled up in the back like a kitty and went to sleep. You know, it's a 6-hour drive from Baltimore to there, so I figured I could handle it, right? And I hear him mumble something about pictures. I also had earplugs in my ears, so I was like, row, 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 row. Several hours later, I wake up to, I hear yelling and chanting. I'm like, what? Where am I? I'm looking around, hot. And, wait a minute, we're in Washington. We're in D.C. Why are we still in D.C.? I checked the time. It's 1 p.m. We left Blue's house, which, by the way, is in Baltimore. Origami and Blue, where they live, is in Baltimore. We're in Washington, D.C. Several hours later, still. Okay, so I try to call JT. Straight to voicemail. I wait and wait and wait and wait and wait and wait and wait. And I figure maybe he's part of the, he's being part of the chanting thing that's going on. Something to do about coal, oil, I don't know, whatever it was. They finally disperse. No JT. I kept trying to call him and call him and call him and call him and call him. Voicemail. 18 voicemails I left. It started off kind of silly, you know, things like, you know, honey, this is not a good way to start our engagement. And by the end of it, I'm like, oh, well. You know, you get the idea. I'm like totally freaking out. So I call Babs and Zabu, see if they could check his Twitter, because I couldn't. He hadn't tweeted in like 3 hours. That's making me nervous. He either got jumped, arrested, or he left me. That was what went through my head, you know? And I still try calling him. Nothing. Finally, I call his mom. You know things are going down when I have to call his mom. And the first thing she, oh, sweetheart, congratulations. Because obviously she already knew. And I'm like, I can't find Jonathan. That was me. And she's like, what? What's the matter? So I tell her. And while I'm on the phone with her, JT is peeking his head up at the hood of the car. Now, mind you, it's hot in the car. The windows are open just a crack. I have to pee. I tried to get out of the car and the alarms went off. Dude! So I was literally trapped in that car. So he pushes a water and a fruit cup through. And I say, oh, he's here. After 6 hours, he's finally here. So we hang up and he comes in and I freak out on him, blah, blah, blah. So, yeah. He left me stranded in a car. Now, he will tell you that he didn't know that was going to happen. And it's true. I mean, the car auto-locked and out and he probably pressed a button for the alarm and didn't even realize it. But there it was, our first test as an engaged couple. I won't ever let him live that down. So, that's the story of our engagement and how oblivious I was. Oh my God, so oblivious. So, check out the video. It really is beautiful. And, if you like this story and any other stories, you know, hit like, hit subscribe, suggest stories to me. Maybe I'll tell one. Maybe, you know, I'll pick a story that you suggest and I'll tell it, you know, within reason. Don't get too weird on me. That's my job. So, that's it. I'm Catalina, and bye! Meow, 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 meow. I just give you? Oh, I gave you the wrong end. Meow.
Ghost won't scare the most. Can you spare me up a little bit of love? I'm the only one that's